Our hero claims got some fresh baked bread and good cheese if you're after a bite
I
to eat.
You, I tell you, the dragon come. With a voice wielding power of the ancient Nordart. Believe.
suffering the Daedra cause will not go unpunished. You speak to a vigilant of Stendar. Cavort with any Daedra, and we will hunt you down.
The Vigil will be watching you.
Wherever the Daedra hide, the Vigil of Stendar will cast them into the light.
Wherever the Daedra hide, the Vigil of Stendar will cast them into the light.
truth is, I've never been anything like this before. I hope you don't mind if I walk up with you. Hey, don't tell Isran I was afraid to meet him by myself. Not the best first impression for a new vampire hunter, I guess. You've probably killed lots of vampires, huh? I'm sure Isran will sign you right up. I'm sure he'll take me. I hope so.
Guard?
Good. Isran will decide if you've got what it takes. Go on, he's right inside.
Why are you here, Tolan? The Vigilance and I were finished with each other a long time ago.
You know why I'm here. The Vigilance are under attack everywhere. The vampires are much more dangerous than we believed.
And now you want to come running to safety with the Dawn Guard, is that it? I remember Keeper Cossette telling me repeatedly that Fort Dawn Guard is a crumbling ruin, not worth the expense and manpower to repair. And now that you've stirred up the vampires against you, you come begging for my protection.
Isran, Cossette is dead. The Hall of the Vigilance, everyone. You were right, we were wrong. Isn't that enough for you?
Yes, ma'am. I never wanted any of this to happen. I tried to warn all of you. I am sorry, you know? So who are you? What do you want? Got a fire in your belly to kill vampires, eh? Good for you. But look around. There's really not much to join yet. I've only just started rebuilding the Order. I need someone out in the field taking a fight to the damn vampires, while we're getting the fort back into shape. Tolan was telling me about some cave the Vigilants were poking around in. Seemed to think it was related to these recent vampire attacks. Tolan, tell him about, what was it? Dim Hollow.
Yes, that's it. Dim Hollow Crypt. Brother Adelwald was sure it held some long-lost vampire artifact of some kind. We didn't listen to him any more than we did Isran. He was at the hall when it was attacked.
That's good enough for me. Go see what the vampires were looking for in this Dim Hollow crypt. With any luck, they'll still be there. Here, you should take a crossbow. Good for taking out those fiends before they get close. Feel free to poke around the fort and take what you need. There isn't much yet, but you're welcome to anything you can use.
I'll meet you at Dim Hollow. It's the least I can do to avenge my fallen comrades.
Tolan, I don't think that's a good idea. You Vigilants were never trained.
I know what you think of us. You think we're soft, that we're cowards. You think our deaths proved our weakness. Stendar granted you do not have to face the same test. And be found wanting.
You there, boy. Stop skulking in the shadows and step up here. What's your name?
My name is Agamir, sir.
Do I look like a sir? I'm not a soldier. If you're not joining the army.
Yes, sir. Isran.
Didn't I tell you to step forward? Farm boy, huh? What's your weapon?
My weapon? I mostly just use my paw's axe. wolves or attacking the goats or something.
My paw's axe. Stendhal preserve us.
Isran found something for you to do, eh? I thought he'd like you. Good luck.
never know when to give up. I thought we'd taught them enough of the lesson at their hall.
To come in here alone, a fool like all the rest of them.
Right.
Stop. I thought we'd taught them enough of the lesson of their hall.
To come in here alone.
I thought I heard something.
Thank you.
I'll never tell you anything, vampire. My oath to Stendar is stronger than any suffering you can inflict on me.
I believe you, Richard. And I don't think you even know what you found. So go and meet your beloved son.
Who sent you here? I don't know who that is. Is he like me? Vampire, yes. Not fond of vampires, are they? Well, look, kill me, you've killed one vampire. But if people are after me, there's something bigger going on. I can help you find out what that is. I was going to say the same thing to you. My family used to live on an island to the west of Solitude. I would guess they still do. By the way, my name is Serana. Good to meet you. Yes, it is. And it's mine. It's complicated. I can't really talk about it. I'm sorry. Not going to happen. Your guess is as good as mine. This place looks pretty different from when I was locked away. Does the air feel heavy down here? I'm a little woozy, but it might just be from waking up.
Come on.
good to breathe again.
Even in this weather, it's better than the cave.
Here.
This must be that beautiful Skyrim weather I've always heard about. So, before we go in there, I wanted to thank you for getting me this far, but after we get in there, I'm going to go my own way for a while.
I think.
I know your friends would probably want to kill everything in here. I'm hoping you can show some more control than that. Once we're inside, just keep quiet for a bit. Let me take the lead.
How dare you trespass here?
Wait, Serana? Is that truly you? I cannot believe my eyes.
My lord, everyone! Serana has returned!
I guess I'm expected.
I can't believe it.
My long-lost daughter returns at last. I trust you have my Elder Scroll.
After all these years, that's the first thing you ask me? Yes, I have the scroll.
Of course, I'm delighted to see you, my daughter. Must I really say the words aloud? Ah, if only your traitor mother were here. I would let her watch this reunion before putting her head on a spike. Now tell me, who is this stranger you have brought into our hall?
This is my savior, the one who freed me.
For my daughter's safe return, you have my gratitude. Tell me, what is your name? I am Harkon, Lord of this court. By now, my daughter will have told you what we are. Not just vampires. We are among the oldest and most powerful vampires in Skyrim. For centuries we lived here, far from the cares of the world. All that ended when my wife betrayed me and stole away that which I valued most. You have done me a great service, and now you must be rewarded. There is but one gift I can give that is equal in value to the Elder Scroll and my daughter. I offer you my blood. Take it and you will walk as a lion among sheep. Men will tremble at your approach and you will never fear death again. Then you will be prey, like all mortals. I will spare your life this once, but you will be banished from this hall. Perhaps you still need convincing. Behold the power! This is the power that I offer. Now, make your choice. So be it. You are prey, like all mortals. I banish you.
I should have known it was only a matter of time before they found us. It's the price we pay for openly recruiting. We'll have to step up our defenses. I don't suppose you have some good news for me. Of course. Why did I suppose differently? Fine. Tell me what you know. A woman? Trapped in there? That doesn't make any sense. Who is she? More importantly, where is she? And so you delivered her to them. They what? And you didn't stop them? You didn't secure the scroll? Right. So they have this woman and an Elder Scroll. By the Divines. This couldn't get much worse. This is more than you and I can handle. Well, of course we do. I'm old, not stupid. We're just going to need some help. If they're bold enough to attack us here, then this may be bigger than I thought. I have good men here. There are people I've met and worked with over the years. We need their skills, their talents, if we're going to survive this. If you can find them, we might have a chance. Right to the point, aren't you? I like that. Not like those fools in the Order. We should keep it small. Too many people and we'll draw unwanted attention to ourselves. I think we'll want Serene Gerard. Breton girl, whip smart and good with tinkering. Fascination with the Dwemer. Weapons in particular. Last I knew, she was out in the Reach, convinced she was about to find the biggest dwarven ruins yet. Might need a little convincing, but she should. You'll also want to find Gunmar, big brute of a Nord, hates vampires almost as much as I do. Got it into his head years back that his experience with animals would help. Trolls in particular, from what I hear. Last I knew, he was out scouring Skyrim for more beasts to tame. Bring the two of them back here, and we can get started on coming up with a plan. There's only one thing worth remembering. When it comes to vampires, if you're sloppy or careless, you're dead. And good people will die because of you. I've lasted this long because I don't take chances. I cover my tracks and I keep my eyes open. If you're smart, you'll do the same. Keep your eyes open.
Delphine has been very worried about you.
We heard the news from Whiterun that you left the city on the back of a dragon. That's a little showy, even for you. Since you're still alive, I assume you have good news to report. Gods above, that's better news than I had hoped. When you walked into my inn that day, I never imagined where it would all lead. Dragons out of legend. Sovngarde.
You've done it. Just as the prophecy said.
Hey, did you say something?
Justice can be harsh, but it is still justice. Parthenax deserves to die. Parthenax was the author of many atrocities during the Dragon War. Crimes great enough to be remembered for thousands of years. True, he turned traitor to Alduin and helped overthrow the Dragon Cult. But that does not excuse or expiate his previous deeds. Whether or not he has truly repented or merely acted to save himself, justice demands that he pay with his life.
I knew you could do it. I believe you could get it.
Thank you.
You there! Hold fast!
I've tracked this damned bear for 2 weeks. I'll not let it have any more victims. Ithron needing someone else's help. Never thought I'd hear that. I'm afraid he's a few years too late. I've moved on. I have more important business to attend to. Besides, he can handle anything alone. He assured me so himself. What could he possibly need my help with? Vampires? That... well, that might change things. Tell me more about what's going on. By the Eight. All right, look. I'll consider it. But I can't just leave this bear to prey on more innocent people. Once it's dealt with, then perhaps I'll see what Ithron expects of me. Stop this creature before it kills again. We need to stop this creature before it kills again. Helped me, so I suppose the least I can do is find out what Ithron wants. He's still at that fort near Stendar's beacon, I assume. Of course he did. He's been working on that place for years now. Never lets anyone in. His own little fortress. Well, I guess I'll get to see what he's been up to all this time. I'll meet you there.
A new hand touches the beacon. Listen, hear me and obey. A foul darkness has seeped into my temple. A darkness that you will destroy. Return my beacon to Mount Kilcreath, and I will make you the instrument of my cleansing light.
haven't seen a sack full of dwarven gyros lying around, have you? I'd swear I left it right here. Do you think mud crabs might have taken it? I saw one the other day. Wouldn't be surprised if it followed me here. Just look around, will you? Isran? Wants me? No, you must be mistaken. He made it exceedingly clear the last time we spoke that he had no interest in my help. I find it hard to believe he's changed his mind. He said some very hurtful things to me before I left. Anyway, I'm quite happy in my current pursuits. So if you'll excuse me... Vampires? Really? Oh, and I suppose now he remembers that I proposed no less than 3 different scenarios that involved vampires overrunning the population. Well, what are they up to? Well, that's actually something I never would have anticipated. Interesting. I'm not sure what they would do with one, but in this case, Isran is probably correct in thinking it isn't good. All right. If nothing else, I suppose it wouldn't hurt to learn more about what's going on so I can better defend myself. But I'm not just going to abandon what I've been working on here. It's too useful. I need at least one intact dwarven gyro. So either I need to find the satchel those mud crabs stole, or I need another gyro from someplace. You wouldn't happen to have one, would you? I'm sorry, but I'm not about to do that with at least a single gyro to show for my efforts. I understand that, but I really can't leave here without at least one usable piece of dwarven equipment. A single gyro would be enough, I think. Believe me, this is useful stuff. Well, then I'm very sorry, but I can't just walk away from this project yet. Good day. Want with my satchel anyway. I understand that, but I really can't. A single gyro would be enough, I think. Thank you. It's not much, but this will help a great deal with some things I've been researching. Now, where is it Isran expects me to go? Ah, been working more on his secret hideout, has he? It'll be interesting to see how much progress he's made. I'll finish up here and head in that direction as soon as I can. See you there. Good day.
All right, Isran. You've got us all here. Now what do you want?
Hold it right there!
What are you doing?
Making sure you're not vampires. Can't be too careful.
So welcome to Fort Dawnguard. I'm sure you've heard a bit of what we're up against. Powerful vampires, unlike anything we've seen before. And they have an Elder Scroll. If anyone is going to stand in their way, it's going to be us.
This is all well and good, but do we actually know anything about what they're doing? What do we do now?
We'll get to that. For now, get acquainted with the space.
Soreen, you'll find room to start your tinkering on that crossbow design you've been working on. Gunmar, there's an area large enough for you to pen up some trolls. Get them armored up and ready for use. In the meantime, we're going to get to the bottom of why a vampire showed up here looking for you. Let's go have a little chat with you, shall we?
So dangerous.
Nothing. Well, not. That's why I always try to be ready for anything.
Yes?
This vampire showed up while you were away. I'm guessing it's the one you found in Dim Hollow Crypt. Says it's got something really important to say to you. So let's hear it.
You probably weren't expecting to see me again. I'd rather not be here either, but I needed to talk to you. It's important, so please just listen before your friend here loses his patience. It's... well, it's about me, and the Elder Scroll that was buried with me. The reason I was down there, and why I had the Elder Scroll, it all comes back to my father. I'm guessing you figured this part out already, but my father's not exactly a good person, even by vampire standards. He wasn't always like that, though. There was... a turn. He stumbled onto this obscure prophecy and... just kind of lost himself in it. It's pointless and vague, like all prophecies. The part he latched onto said that vampires would no longer need to fear the sun. That's what he's after. He wants to control the sun. Have vampires control the world. Anyway, my mother and I didn't feel like inviting a war with all of Tamriel, so we tried to stop him. That's why I was sealed away with the scroll. I did, but something about you makes me think I can trust you. I hope I'm not wrong. Well, let's move then. I'm nothing if not persuasive.
All right, you've heard what it has to say. Now tell me. Is there any reason I shouldn't kill this blood-sucking fiend right now?
Why? Because of that story about the prophecy, about some vampire trying to put the sun out?
Do you actually believe any of that?
Who knows? Maybe it has a death wish. Maybe it's just insane. I don't really care.
It can stay for now. But if it so much as lays a finger on anyone here, I'll hold you responsible. Got it. You hear me? Don't feel like a guest, because you're not. You're a resource. You're an asset. In the meantime, don't make me regret my sudden outburst of tolerance and generosity. Because if you do, your friend here is going to pay for it.
Thank you for your kindness. I'll remember it the next time I'm feeling hungry. So, in case you didn't notice the giant thing on my back, I have the Elder Scroll with me. Whatever it says, it will have something that can help us stop my father. But, of course, neither of us can read it. Well, the Moth Priests are the only ones I've heard of who can do it. They spend years preparing before they start reading, though. Not that it helps us anyway, because they're all half a continent away, in Cyrodiil.
Some Imperial scholar arrived in Skyrim a few days ago. I was staking out the road when I saw him pass by. Maybe that's your Moth Priest.
Do you know where he's staying now?
No, and I'm not going to waste men looking. We're fighting a war against your kind, and I intend to win it. You want to find him? Try talking to anyone who'd meet a traveler. Innkeepers and carriage drivers in the big cities, maybe. But you're on your own.
Any idea how you're going to find a Moth Priest? Skyrim's a pretty big place. Well, back before I... you know. The College of Winterhold was the first place I'd think to go for any kind of magic or historical thing. The wizards know about all kinds of things that people probably shouldn't know about. Actually, now that I think of it, I'm going to come along with you. I've been really wanting to get out and explore a bit. Alright, let's see what you have.
Welcome to the college.
Hundreds of years have gone into assembling this collection. It's going to stay pristine, understand? A Moth Priest? What in Oblivion do you need a Moth Priest for? Fine, fine. No need to get your britches in a twist. The obvious answer is to go to the Imperial City. The Moth Priest make their home in the White Gold Tower. Sometimes they go out looking for Elder Scrolls. Lucky for you, there's a Moth Priest in Skyrim right now, doing just that. He stopped in to do some research in the library, then left for Dragonbridge. If you hurry, you might catch him there.
Hmm.
Keep your guard up. Keep an eye out for trouble. It's only a matter of time.
Something different about you, I can tell. Hope you ain't here to cause trouble.
Ancient tongue, you are Dovahkiin, Dragonborn. Ah, so that was a moth priest then. He rode through town not long ago with an escort of soldiers. They didn't stop, just headed south across the Dragon Bridge.